Hi everyone, this is Ross from ggCircuit, and today I'm going to be covering the administration system for the quests and challenges inside ggLeap. To access this functionality, simply click on the events button on the nav bar on the left hand side of the web administrator. And as a quick recap, the arcade system, which consists of configurable quests and challenges, is a player engagement system that allows you to create asynchronous casual competitions for your players. From a business perspective, the goal is to have a fully automated competition system that requires no staff intervention while delivering a compelling and rewarding experience. And it gives your players a purpose for their visit at your venue as well. And for our EDU customers, the arcade system is a fantastic educational tool that allows you to create customized competitions for your students as part of your curriculum. So to cover the functionality on this screen, we can see that in my test environment, I have a total of 32 challenges and 71 quests, some of which are expired, active, or upcoming. This is the total. And they are categorized on a per game basis. So these are the games that are supported in the first version, with Rocket League being the next game that will be supported. Looking at the filters, active challenges are challenges which will appear in the ggLeap client. We'll be actively tracking the data from gamers who are playing in Fortnite, in this example, as per the rules of these individual challenges. And on the right, we can see the total prize pool for each category. So these are non-repeatable challenges, which means that they're configured to be a one-off challenge as opposed to a daily challenge, for example. And the daily challenges are configured to be independent competitions that repeat on a daily basis. So it'll be a daily competition with a daily leaderboard and a daily group of winners. And that will be fully automated and will run until you've configured it to expire or perhaps never expire. As well as the daily challenges, you can also configure those to be weekly or monthly, and you can even have custom repeatability. So perhaps you want to configure a challenge that's only available at the weekends, but happens every weekend, for example. Okay, so let's have a quick look at some of these challenges that are available in my test location, and then we can go through some of the examples of how these were created. So just quickly having a look at the Battle Royale Champion challenge, which is currently running. There's 105 participants. These are the points that have been gained by the player so far. This is the total prize pool that's up for grabs. Again, these can be coins that can be spent by players if there is a prize system in play. Otherwise, these are just total points available at the end based on position. And as you can see, this is how that is broken down. This is the date range for the specific challenge. So it's going to be recording data over this quite a long period of time. And then the winners at the end will be those players who are in these positions. This is how the formula is calculated, which we'll go over in detail later on. And this is the challenge summary for this particular challenge. As a sort of TLDR, this challenge awards 3 points for a kill, and it awards extra points based on position. So it's kind of a standard Fortnite formula points system. It will reward players who play well in Fortnite generally. Whereas we can do something a little bit more custom and change the way that gamers should attempt to play the game in order to succeed in this challenge. This is an ultimate camper challenge, so it actually rewards players based on being able to win the game with as few kills as possible. So it really is about hiding and camping and sneaking around. It can be a fun challenge for players who like to play in this way. And so in this particular example, you actually get 0 points unless you win the game. But if you do win the game, you lose 1 point for every kill that you've got along the way. So the highest possible is 100 points. I'm not sure if that's actually possible to win a game with 0 kills, but that is the goal. And to have a look at some of these other ones just very quickly. So this is a League of Legends challenge that rewards a carry type of hero. Basically anyone who contributes significantly to the game in terms of kills. Also when they win the game, it's important bonus points here. And obviously dying the fewest. This is a formula that we can use to try and find who are the good carry heroes in our community. And Valorant, for example, so here's a challenge for support heroes. So this will incentivize players to play well as a support and attribute points based on playing well as that role. And this is a slightly more complicated formula for Dota 2, but it's rewarding as a support as well. So it's attributing points based on healing and assisting. Okay, and finally, just to wrap up, this events screen will summarize the challenges, quests that you have created or have enabled for your venue. There is a button to create a new challenge here as well. So from here, you can go ahead and create one from scratch and go through all of the step-by-step instructions to do that. Or if you prefer, you can simply enable one of these templates that we've created for you. So we'll keep adding challenges and quests to the template system so that you can just quickly enable them. You can also enable them and then make tweaks to them. So you can change the formula that we've created if you prefer to make some changes. It can often be easier to do that rather than creating one from scratch. But there's plenty of options here. We'll cover all of those in the next video. If you do have any questions or comments or suggestions, I would really appreciate it if you could leave a comment. Thanks a lot, guys.